ഈ സഭയിൽ ശുശ്രൂഷിക്കുന്ന കർത്താവിന്റെ ദാസനും കുടുംബത്തിനും സന്നിധിയിലായിരിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാ ദൈവങ്ങൾക്കും വേഗം വരുന്ന കർത്താവിന്റെ വിലയേറിയ നാമത്തിൽ സ്നേഹവന്ദനത്തെ അറിയിക്കും.
I bring greetings to you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
ഇന്നലെ രാത്രിയിൽ ഇവിടെ മീറ്റിംഗിൽ ദൈവം പ്രസംഗിക്കാനായി അവകാശം ഒരുക്കി.
The Lord gave me opportunity to preach from the word of God here last night.
ചില ആഴ്ചകളായി എന്റെ വൈഭവ ഈ പ്രദേശത്തായിരുന്നു ഈ ചർച്ചുമായിട്ടുള്ള കൂട്ടായ്മയിൽ കടന്നു വരുവാനും നിങ്ങൾ കാണിച്ച എല്ലാ സഹകരണത്തിനും എന്റെ ഹൃദയമായി നന്ദി ഞാൻ അറിയിക്കും.
For the last several weeks, my wife was here in town and she was worshiping with you all. And I thank you all for all the support that you have given to her and our family.
എന്റെ മകൾ പ്രേസിയും സണ്ണിലോസും പോലും കൊച്ചു വൈദ്യനുമായിട്ട് കാലേബുമായി ഒന്നിച്ച ദൈവഭാഗ്യായിരിക്കാൻ
Especially I thank God for my son-in-law's mother and my daughter Praisi. With their son Caleb, they are able to come here for stand with their son. And I thank God for that. I am so delighted to say that my heart is full of joy to see my grandson here first time. And the coming days, my great desire is for my children to come here, worship with you, and if you pray, the Lord will make opportunity. Another thing that gives me great joy is that my sister-in-law, Santa, and her husband, Dr. Kurula, is visiting with us here this Sunday morning. And it also brings me joy, and I praise God for above all.
ഇന്ന് സമയം കുറവായതുകൊണ്ട് വലിയ വിഷയം എടുക്കാൻ ഞാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നില്ല. ഒരു മണിക്ക് യോഗം തീർക്കണമെന്നാണ് എന്റെ ആഗ്രഹം. കാരണം എനിക്കും ഇന്ന് സഭയം കഴിഞ്ഞ് ഡാളസിലോട്ടുള്ള യാത്ര ഞങ്ങൾ ആരംഭിക്കുകയാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ലേറ്റായാൽ എനിക്കും ക്ഷീണമാ. അതുകൊണ്ട് കൃത്യം ഒരു മണിക്ക് തന്നെ മീറ്റിംഗ് അവസാനിപ്പിക്കത്തക്ക രീതിയിൽ ഒരു മെസ്സേജ് ആണ് ഞാൻ അറേഞ്ച്
ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. At 1 o'clock I want to end, so I can also travel to Dallas after this Sunday service.
ഞാൻ ഇന്ന് പ്രസംഗിക്കാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ വാഴ്ത്തപ്പെട്ട കർത്താവ് ഭൂമിയിലായിരുന്നപ്പോൾ യേശു അനേക പ്രാവശ്യം അന്നുണ്ടായിരുന്ന ദൈവാലയത്തിൽ സന്ദർശിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി.
And I like to talk about the message this morning about our blessed Lord Jesus Christ when he was upon the face of the earth. He visited many churches on those days. The temple in Jerusalem was visited by the Lord.
അങ്ങനെ സന്ദർശിച്ച അവസരത്തിൽ ആറ് കാര്യങ്ങൾ യേശു ദൈവാലയത്തിൽ ചെയ്തു.
When he visited the temple, he has done six specific things.
അങ്ങനെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ രണ്ടോ മൂന്നോ പേർ എന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ കൂടി വന്നിടത്തൊക്കെയും ഞാൻ അവിടെ നടുവിൽ ഉണ്ട് എന്നല്ല ചെയ്താൽ കർത്താവ് ഇന്ന് നമ്മുടെ മധ്യത്തിൽ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ കർത്താവ് അന്ന് ചെയ്ത ആറ് കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഇന്നും നമ്മുടെ മധ്യേ നടന്നു കാണുവാൻ കർത്താവ് ആഗ്രഹിക്കും.
If so, the Lord have said, if two or three come gather together in my name, I will be in their midst. That Lord Jesus is here this morning. If so, he has done six things in the time past. His desire is to do those six things again, repeating that in this place.
നമ്മുടെ പിതാക്കന്മാരായ അബ്രഹാം, ഇസ്ഹാക്, യാക്കോബ് ഒക്കെ ജീവിച്ച കാലയളവിൽ അന്ന് ദൈവാലയം ഇല്ലായിരുന്നു. അവർ കൂടാരം മാറ്റിയടിക്കുകയും സൗകര്യപ്രദമാകുന്ന സ്ഥലത്ത് യാഗപീഠങ്ങൾ പണിത് ദൈവത്തെ ആരാധിക്കുകയുമായിരുന്നു അവർ ചെയ്തു വന്നിരുന്നത്.
അവർ ഫോർ ഫാദേഴ്സ് ഏബ്രഹാം, Isaac and Jacob and so called forefathers were worshipping and they were living in tents, moving from tent to tent, and they were erecting the altars wherever they moved and worshipped there in truth.
എന്നാൽ മിസ്രയീമിലായിരുന്ന ഇസ്രായേൽ മക്കൾ പെസഹ കുഞ്ഞാടിന്റെ ചോരയാൽ വീണ്ടെടുക്കപ്പെട്ട് ചെങ്കടൽ കടന്ന് സ്നാനപ്പെട്ട് മരുഭൂമിയിൽ കയറിയപ്പോൾ ദൈവം പറഞ്ഞു, ഇനി ഞാൻ നിങ്ങളുടെ നടുവിൽ വസിപ്പാൻ നിങ്ങൾ എനിക്ക് ഒരു വിശുദ്ധ മന്ദിരം പണിവാൻ.
But the Lord commanded to the generation of Israel after they left the bondage of Egypt through the Red Sea into the wilderness by the Passover lamb. The Lord said, now I want to live among you, for me to dwell in your midst, make me a tabernacle.
അങ്ങനെ ആദ്യമേ പണിത ദൈവാലയമാണ് സമാഗമന കൂടാരം.
The first temple of God is called the tabernacle. The place that the Lord appeared was the temple of God.
അവർ പാളയം മാറ്റി മാറ്റി അടിക്കുമ്പോൾ ഈ ദൈവാലയത്തിന്റെ ഭാഗങ്ങൾ ചുമന്നുകൊണ്ടുപോയി അവര് പാർക്കുന്ന സ്ഥലത്ത് അങ്ങനെ ഈ ദൈവാലയം സ്ഥാപിച്ച് അവർ കുർബാനമായി അങ്ങനെ ആരാധിച്ച് മുമ്പോട്ട് പോയി.
Those days the worship place were not made out of stones, but they were called the tabernacle, made of tent. They moved the tent from place to place as they were moving from place to place, and they put the stake and the tent together to worship the Lord there.
ഈ സമാഗമകൂടാരം പണിയേണ്ട വിധത്തിൽ മോശയുടെ ഇഷ്ടപ്രകാരമാണ് ചെയ്തത്. മോശയെ ദൈവം പർവ്വതത്തിൽ വിളിച്ചിട്ട് സ്ഥാപിപ്പാൻ പോകുന്ന സമാഗമന കൂടാരം മുഴുവൻ പ്ലാനും സ്കെച്ചും എല്ലാം വരച്ച് അതിന്റെ കുറ്റിയും കൊളുത്തും വരെ എന്തായിരിക്കണമെന്ന് വ്യക്തമായി ഓർമ്മപ്പെടുത്തിയാണ് മോശ താഴേക്ക് അയച്ചത്.
The tabernacle was built in the wilderness not according to the will of Moses, but God gave him the instruction, the proper design, even to the minute detail of the building of the tabernacle to Moses, and revealed it to him. And then Moses made according to the plan that was given by God.
Moses, Aaronu maanara deivam pratheekam paranju parvarathil vecha njan kaanichu thanna maandruga prakaram thanne neeve undaakkuvan soochichu kollayanam.
And God told Moses that you be very careful that you only build the ark and the tabernacle according to the pattern that I have shown you on the top of the mountain.
Angara vanna samagama kudare homa kalpichana pole pravarthi samaapichappol devathinte shakthina ee aalayathinte irangi varugayum devam samagama kudarathe angeekarikkeyge.
And as soon as Moses completed the building of the tabernacle per the commandment of God, and at for the fulfillment, the Shekinah glory from heaven came down upon the tabernacle, and God approved this worship place.
Apostle Peter അധ്യായത്തിൽ സ്തേഫാനോസ് പ്രസംഗിക്കുമ്പോൾ പറയുകയാണ് നമ്മുടെ പിതാക്കന്മാർ ഈ സമാഗമന കൂടാരം ഏറ്റുവാങ്ങി ദാവീദിന്റെ കാലം വരെ വെച്ചിരുന്നു.
And when Stephen was giving the preaching in the New Testament Acts of the Apostles, he says that our forefathers received this tabernacle and kept it under their protection for the continuing worship.
എല്ലാവരും പ്രത്യേക ശ്രദ്ധിക്കണം, മൊത്തമുള്ള ദൈവാലയം ഏഴെണ്ണമാണ്.
Everybody be careful here, the total the worship place are seven.
ഒന്നാമത്തെ ദൈവാലയത്തിന്റെ പേര് സമാഗമന കൂടാരം.
The first one is the tabernacle.
അത് ദാവീദ് രാജാവിന്റെ കാലം വരെ വെച്ചിരുന്നു.
It was there till the time of King David.
ദാവീദ് പറഞ്ഞു, ഞാൻ ദേവദാരു കൊണ്ടുള്ള വലിയ പാലസിൽ അരമനയിൽ ഞാൻ പാർക്കുന്നു, ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ആലയം തിരശീലകൾക്കകത്ത് പൊരിഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നു, അത് യോഗ്യമല്ല, ദൈവത്തിന് തക്കളായ മഹത്വം കൊടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ ഒരു ദൈവാലയം പണിയുമെന്ന് ദാവീദ് തീരുമാനിച്ചു.
And David said that I am living in a palace that is made with the shittim wood, but the Lord is in the tabernacle, so I will build a temple for him.
ഉടനെ ദൈവം ഒരു പ്രവാചകനെ പറഞ്ഞയച്ചിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞു, നിന്റെ കൈ രക്തം ചൊരിയിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, നീ എനിക്ക് ആലയം പണിയണ്ട, നിന്റെ മകൻ ശലോമോൻ എനിക്ക് ആലയം പണിയുമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു.
During the course of his thought process, God sent a prophet unto David and said, your hand has shed much blood, I will not allow you to build me a tabernacle, but your son will build me a tabernacle.
എന്നാ ദൈവാലയം പണിയേണ്ട വെള്ളി പൊന്ന് തടി വേണ്ട എല്ലാ സാധനങ്ങളും ദാവീദ് തന്നെ ഒരുക്കി വെച്ചു.
And David had prepared all the materials to build the temple, which are gold, silver and all the woods.
അങ്ങനെ സലോമോൻ പണിത ദൈവാലയമാണ് രണ്ടാമത്തെ ദൈവാലയം, അതിന്റെ പേര് സലോമോന്റെ ദൈവാലയം.
The second worship place is the temple that is built by Solomon. It is called the Solomon's temple.
ലോകം കണ്ടിട്ടുള്ളതിൽ വെച്ച് ഏറ്റവും വലിയ ദൈവാലയം സലോമോന്റെ ദൈവാലയമായി.
The world have ever seen such a temple like that which was built by King Solomon.
സലോമോൻ ദൈവാലയം പണിത ശേഷം ഒരു പീഠം കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് നിന്നിട്ട് ആ പീഠത്തിന്റെ മുട്ടിന്മേൽ നിന്ന് കൈകൾ രണ്ടും പരത്തി ദൈവത്തിനോട് ഒരു പ്രാർത്ഥനയുണ്ട്. ബൈബിളിലെ ഏറ്റവും നീണ്ട
After completing the temple of God, Solomon brought a footstool before the temple and stood on it and lifted his both hands up into heaven and prayed a long prayer. Such a prayer is the lengthy prayer that is written recorded in the Word of God. Upon completion of the prayer of Solomon, King Solomon, the glory of the Lord, the Shekinah glory of the Lord came upon this Solomon's temple, and God approved this temple as a place of worship. And during the course of the reign of the kings in the land of Israel and Judah, and the children of Israel have forsaken the living God, they departed worshiping the living God. Instead, they placed idols in the temple of God. The glory of the Lord departed the temple of God. Children of God were taken captive in the land of Babylonia for 70 years. During the time King Nebuchadnezzar came and besieged the temple at Jerusalem and burned this temple in fire and took all the instruments and the vessels of the temple of God into Babylonia and put in the temple of their gods over there. And during that time it came to an end to the empire of Babylon, and the empire of Mede and Persia came into existence. During that time, the king of Cyrus was stirred by the Holy Spirit. And before the birth of the King Cyrus, God the Holy Spirit prophesied a prophecy. It is recorded in the prophetical book of Isaiah about his birth and the reign and the things that he will do in the coming days. When Isaiah the prophet was prophesying the prophecy on Cyrus was not born. And the history says that when Cyrus became the king, he was reigning in the land, Daniel went to show himself before the king, and during the time, Daniel was carrying a prophetical book of Isaiah with him. Because Cyrus the king heard about Daniel the prophet, he gave him a great invitation and he started listening to the word of God. During the time Daniel wrote that Daniel, king, you are made and you are here because of God's purpose, and you will rebuild the temple, and that gave a great joy in the king's heart. And the king ordered that the place where King Nebuchadnezzar destroyed the temple, there the new temple should be built. And the third temple was erected by the commandment of King Cyrus, by the leadership of Zerubbabel. This third temple is called the temple of Zerubbabel.
Zerubbabel
When we study history, we see during the time of BC 170, this temple of Zerubbabel was destroyed.
BC 170, Syria rajavane Antiochia Sepiphanas ee aalayathinte bhagangal idichukalagayum aa yagavidathinte devathin arumbaya pandiye kondu vandu yagam arpikkayum cheythu.
During the time Antiochus Epiphanes came and besieged the city and destroyed the temple of God, and on the altar he came, which was not approved by God, he offered a pig upon the altar and started sacrificing for
God.
After that many years, the children of Israel went without a temple of God. During the time of Roman Empire, the King Herod gave a commandment to build a temple to please Jews, and that temple was built, and the name of the temple is the Temple of King Herod. And during the time people were worshipping in that temple, the Lord Jesus Christ was born in the city of Bethlehem. The first temple is the tabernacle. He was there till the time of David.
The
second temple is the temple of Solomon. It was besieged by the king Nebuchadnezzar. The third temple is the temple of
Zerubbabel.
It was destroyed by Antiochus Epiphanes of Syria. The fourth temple is the temple of Herod. In this temple of Herod, the Jesus' parents brought Jesus as a baby to dedicate himself unto the Lord. Six things that the Lord have done in this temple. This is what I am going to preach to you. This temple of Herodias is no more. During the persecution, suffering, death of the Lord Jesus Christ, the children of Israel said, "Let your blood be upon us and our generation to generation." And the disciples showed Jesus Christ this temple and said, "Lord Jesus, look at this temple, how beautiful it is." And the Lord said, "The stone will not lay upon stone." And Jesus looked at the beauty of Jerusalem and the city of Jerusalem and the temple, and he was weeping and prophesying the things to come in the near future. He said, this temple will be destroyed and stone will not lay upon stone. During the time of AD 70, the army of Titus came to Jerusalem. The whole land of Jerusalem was suffering with the famine. I don't have time to explain, but the people living in Jerusalem, because the Jerusalem city was surrounded by the army, there was no food supplies, they were eating everything, but they can see there is living or creeping things, including dog and any leaves they can find. And the army of Titus came inside. 130,000 Israelites were slain during that, or persecuted or killed by the sword of King of Titus. Rest of them were nailed on the tree. And the blood was running like river up to the height of horse. And Titus has said that as a memory for my taking over the city, let this temple be in its place. But a soldier did not listen to the word of King Titus. He put a fire and upon the temple and destroyed the temple. And that fire destroyed the whole temple. All the gilded work of gold melted down and came to the foundation
stone.
And somebody sent a rumor out that saying that all the treasures of Israel is under the foundation of this
temple.
To find the treasures under this foundation, especially equipped elephants with the plows were brought, and elephant plowed even the foundation, and the stone will not stay there on another stone. The temple was until today, as I am preaching, there is no temple for the Jewish nation in Israel. Today, where the temple was before, there is a Muslim temple called Dome of the Rock, is still in that place. During the feast of Jewish nation, the Jewish people, Israel people come around this temple, and they walk around the stones of this old temple, and hitting their forehead upon the stone, and they pray. This is called the Wailing Wall. Let me bring you a good news. All the preparation is done for to rebuild the temple again. And also they even cast a lot to find the priest who should be in charge of this temple. You have to remember this: when there is one temple, there is no other temple. Even though Jewish nation do not understand, there is one temple is in the presence of God. And the Apostle Paul is proclaiming about the temple. Apostle Paul is writing like this, that the church is the living temple of God, which is the pillar of truth. Today's temple is God, the church, which is the temple of God. God does not dwell in the temple, it was built by man. His promise is that the two or three gather in my name, in their midst I am. What the Lord says, the Lord added to the church who are saved. Why Jewish people are not building the temple again? Because the church, the temple of God, is now upon the face of
the earth.
Praise God. Before the Jewish nation build their last temple, the Lord Jesus Christ will come and take his church of God into the heavenly
place.
The next temple Israel will be building by the help of Antichrist. After 3.5 years during the tribulation period, Antichrist will come and erect his idol in the midst of the temple. And the Jews will come against the Antichrist. Antichrist will put an army surrounding the temple. And this army will break down part of this temple. And during that time, the worship of the Antichrist will be invited into this temple. During the time, a great earthquake will come and this temple will be destroyed. But during the time of 1,000 years of rain, there will be another temple.
5-6 things within the next 10 minutes.
The first and foremost, number one thing that Jesus did is he went to the temple and started teaching the congregation.
She read,
Jeremiah chapter 22 verse 10. You do not weep for the dead, neither bemoan him, but weep sore for him that goeth away, for he shall not return anymore, nor see his native country. Now the brother is crying, instead of good thing, bad thing is coming. Don't read anything and everything. And it is important for the Lord Jesus Christ to preach the word. Second thing, a woman who was caught for adultery was brought into the temple of God. And every one of these leaders had stone in their hands. And all these leaders brought this woman and said, "Oh master, she was caught for adultery. We must stone her to death." Immediately the Lord replied, "Any one of you without sin must cast the first stone upon her." And Jesus Christ bent down and started writing on the ground. And many scholars say the Lord Jesus Christ was writing about the sin of all those leaders, but whatever it could be, all those left and fled. I believe all those people brought this lady was much better than us. And the Lord said, "Didn't any one of them judge you?" No. I am also not judging you. Sin no more. What will happen if Jesus is in the church of God? Oh, the sin will be forgiven. If anyone comes into the church of God, forgiveness of sin will be given to those sinners who came into the church. Not only sinners will be forgiven from their sin, believers have committed sin in their day-to-day life will be forgiven and washed by the word of God and by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Number 3. Matthew chapter 21 verse 14. And the lame and the blind came and he healed them all. If Jesus Christ is in the church, what will happen? Healing of the sick will take place. Our Lord not only gives the forgiveness of sin, He has forgiven all our iniquities. He heals all your diseases. When you come to the church of God, you will not go back home as a sinner. If you pray to God, if the Lord is in the church of God, in the church of God, healing will take place. Number 4. Luke chapter 21 verse 1 through 4. The Lord Jesus Christ looked at people offering in the treasuries. Number 1, he gave teaching. Second, sins were forgiven. Healed the sick. And not only number 4, he is watching what you are giving to the Lord. When you come, the offering time comes, the pastors and other believers may not have seen what you have done. But you are folding your hand and putting it $1, the Lord has seen. And the rich man came because gave their richness. A poor widow came and she put 2 pence. And the Holy Spirit went, Jesus Christ went into her house in Holy Spirit. And he lifted up all the vessels in her home and found there's none for her daily living. And the Lord proclaimed, she gave above all. And when you give to the Lord, God is watching every one of you. all the money start complaining.
Orang yang ayat ini nanti kalau pergi market lupa demand orang ini apa yang dicintai orang ini ni apa? Orang peralahan yang kalbi kita tu mana?
And $1,000 bill boasted and said, I am in high demand bank and all the big stores always look for the $1,000 bill. And the $500 bill said, I am also in prominent place there. Right after $1,000 bill, I am taking the second place. And the $100 bill also had a testimony of himself. Lastly, the $1 bill stood up. This is what I heard that he said, I have no ability to stand before any one of you. But I am challenging you. Have any one of you had the opportunity to go to the church of God and go through the offering plate? I can boast in the presence of God very humbly. God gave me the privilege to go through every church of God and walk through the offering plate because I am $1 bill.
Seriously, our number pays to work more. And you are going to buy. Who is going to buy? 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 Who is going to buy?
When we open our wallet to give offering, we see the 1,000, we hide behind the 500 and say, you go behind, and then 500 comes up, we push that down and take the $1 bill saying, the 500 and 1,000 is for me to go to fish market, for me to get the best fish for my meal for the week. In India, the people will not do transaction with the torn rupees. And as I was traveling through the city of Bombay, a pastor was in a store buying some grocery. This poor pastor said, oh pastor, sorry to say this, I cannot buy grocery because the store managers won't take my money because I got this money from offering plate. They will not take half of the money because half of them are torn in pieces. They will not take
it.
That day I made a decision in my life. When I go to the offering plate, I will find the best new currency and put it in the offering plate. And I also convey this message to my children. And have you seen some people give the offering through the left hand? And do you shake hand with the left hand? Let me remind you, when you give to the Lord, make sure you give very decently with your right hand to the Lord. If Jesus is in the church, he will watch what you are giving to the Lord. Number
5.
Mark chapter 11 verse 11. Jesus came to that temple and he did nothing. He walked around the temple and then he went returned home. And what will happen when the Jesus Christ
comes?
He will not sit in one place. He walked around in the midst of the
people.
Even if you find the last seat, he will come near
you.
And the book of Revelation is teaching about 7 churches. And the Holy Spirit is walking in the midst of all the 7 churches. The first one he is entering is the church of Ephesus. And all the believers in the church of Ephesus are great mighty men. Believers in the church, even called the big apostles, are thieves. But the Holy Spirit is saying that you have one fault, that you have lost your first love. And the first century believers, when they greet one another, when they see one another, they greet one another with a famous word of Maranatha. And after that, they start giving kisses. And the kiss went away. Now the routine, the norm is to shake hands. And shake hand is gone. Now the shaking of the head is there. Now you don't even look at a brother. You will say we gather in one church, but one to the other, they don't know. I tell you about two brothers when I was in Gulf countries. There was a big mighty man. He will come and give me a hug after the Holy Communion. I am so afraid when he comes because he's like a giant. My ribs will break. So I'm afraid. But even I enjoyed his warm, loving hug. There is a genuineness in his hug. And there is another brother. When I went to shake hand, he only stretched out two of his fingers. And then the Holy Spirit went to the church in Sardis. Even though you are claimed that you are alive, but you are dead. And at the door they heard a great sound. They came inside and found it is dead church. It's just like a toy that is wound up. And if you wind up a toy, it will clap till the winding is done. And the pastor will say, let us thank God for what he blessed us. Everybody will say, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let us thank God for the healing. Everybody say, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. You are like a machine. As the pastor says, you will do it. The Holy Spirit is walking. And then he came to our church. Not our church. Church of Laodicea. This is the period of Laodicea. The church is a wealthy man's church. They worship putting their one leg over the other leg and sit like a prominent man. And they wear a suit and a black sunglass and sit there like a movie star. And their attitude is, I am so rich in everything, I don't have anything, I'm lacking nothing. If you go to teach them, they are so eloquent in teaching you back. When I walk in there, I found out they are naked, they are not even putting the right clothes. They are blind, so they cannot even see their
clothes.
But their action, their act is like they are big and macho. And the Holy Spirit said, I am going to spew you out. I am going to spew you out. And if Christ comes into our church, he will walk among us. The sixth thing I want to say, Matthew chapter 21 and verse 12. John chapter 2 verse 13 and 16. He made a whip. He found the merchant and whipped them out. My church is called the house of prayer. But you have made the den of thieves. He whipped and cast away all the merchants who were selling the cattle. He cast down all the table with money. And who were selling the dow, he said, take them away. What the Lord Jesus Christ is feeling. He need the dow. He need the cattle. Business is not allowed in the church. Today, the spirituality is changed into business. Cheating and mockery is taking place in the church of God. After casting away all this, all the blind and the lame came near to the Lord. He healed the The blind cannot see. And they will touch and feel to find the temple of God. And suppose they came and touched the horn of the bull in the temple. It will shake the head with the horn and this man will be cast far away. And all this blind is outside the church of God. And some churches, if you go, they take the Bible to give you a message to, point, you know, to make you upset, to point you by purpose. So that nobody will go to the church. When that kind of people go outside the church of God, the blind and the lame will come into the church. God will heal them. Let me stop here. Number one, he taught. Second, he gave forgiveness of sins. Three, he healed the sick. He watched what you are giving. He walked around. And he cleansed the temple. Let the, all these things will happen in our church.
നന്ദി പറയുന്നു. ഞങ്ങൾ ഇന്ന് നാല് മണിയാകുമ്പോൾ ട്രെയിൻ ചെയ്താൽ ഡാലസിൽ പോകുന്നത് നാളെ വൈകിട്ട് കർത്താവെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ അങ്ങ് ചെല്ലുവാനാണ് പ്ലാൻ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഞങ്ങളുടെ യാത്രയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദൈവമക്കളെല്ലാം പ്രത്യേകം പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കണം. നിങ്ങൾ ഡാലസിൽ വരുമ്പോൾ മറക്കരുത്, ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ വീട്ടിലും വരണം, ഞാൻ ശുശ്രൂഷിക്കുന്ന സഭയിലും വരണം. നിങ്ങൾ യൂട്യൂബിൽ കയറിയിട്ട് പിയപുരം ജോർജ് കുട്ടി അടിച്ചാൽ എൻ്റെ 12 പ്രസംഗങ്ങൾ അതിനകത്തുണ്ട്. How to lead a blessed family. ഒരു കുടുംബജീവിതത്തിന് 30 കാരണങ്ങൾ അതിനകത്ത് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. നിങ്ങൾ എല്ലാവരും സമയമുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ യൂട്യൂബിൽ കയറി ബിയപുരം എന്റെ പുസ്തകത്തിനകത്തുണ്ട് ബിയപുരത്തിന്റെ സ്പെല്ലിംഗ് BEYPURAM. ബിയപുരം ജോർജ് കുട്ടി അടിച്ചാൽ എന്റെ പ്രസംഗങ്ങൾ കേട്ടും. ബിഫോർ ഡെത്ത് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഡെത്ത് നല്ല പ്രസംഗങ്ങളാണ് നിങ്ങൾ കേൾക്കണം. ദൈവം
അംഗീകരിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ. Go to the YouTube. I just want to add to that. One more thing I want to add. Pastor forgot to say. Now, he also wrote a book about alcoholics or alcoholism. And a Malayali in Kerala was reading this. It's written in Malayalam. He was a heavy alcoholic. And he read the book and called the pastor here in America and said, "Pastor, I stopped my alcoholism because of reading your book. It changed my life." There are many other good books you can find in the in his library and the YouTube. May God bless him. And this morning I want to say that we have one more person that I forgot to mention first time. James Moody is here, first time worshipping with us. I am very thankful to announce that he is here. And also Dr. Monica's mom is going to India this week.